Welcome back. We might have heard in the news that former Hey Dad star and convicted paedophile Robert Hughes had his appeal dismissed by the High Court, which is as far as he can go. In court for the final decision was one of his victims and on-screen daughter, Sarah Monahan, and she joins us now. Welcome back to the show. Sarah, you live in the United States now and you flew home to be here for the court case. Why was that so important to you?
I didn't get to go to a lot of the other ones just because they didn't want me there for the media presence and to affect future ones. And we got their email, I think, last Wednesday that they were going to announce it. And I looked at my husband and said, I want to go home. And he goes, OK, take my frequent flyer miles. And I booked a flight the next day.
So did you see him in court?
No, he didn't turn up. It was just the High Court judges that came in. And they actually had a whole bunch of different things and we were first on the docket.
Would you be OK? Would you have been OK to eyeball him in court?
Maybe.
Mm. I've got to say, when I see the old images of him and you together, it just makes me sick.
The first day in court, I couldn't. Yeah. And then each day I stared him down a little bit more. Mm. And by the fourth day, I was like
good on you.
Yeah,
this has been a 30-year thing, actually, since you started on the show in 87, right? So he's now, mercifully...
Yes.
Exhausted all the legal options. But for you, the knot in the tummy, what's it been like for you, the toll after
7 years? After appeal? I mean, I have friends who had babies born the week I went public, and they're now 7. And I'm like, that's like, I'm 40 years old. And it's like, that's just such an enormous chunk. But now it's over, so I can, thankfully.
So do you feel lighter then? Is there a part of you now that feels a little...
Yeah. And like last night, it was like, it took a few hours for it to really, settle and come in and go, oh my God, it's really done. And now I'm like, oh, I can get on with life. Because before it was like, I want to start my clothing line, but at the same time I'm like, what if I start it and then I have to go back to court? And it interrupts everything.
Your life's been on hold.
It is. It's like I just quit working because it was like, do I have to go back to court and I have to take time off? And everything is constantly on hold, and so now I can live.
Mm-hmm. You've had an amazing support network around you, obviously.
Sarah, you only met your other victim, the other victims, for the first time yesterday.
Yes.
What was that like meeting them, and why hadn't you met them before?
We were never allowed to meet because they didn't want us to say that, we were colluding or something like that.
Of course.
And there was one girl who had actually gone to the police about Robert Hughes a couple times before my stuff came out. When my stuff came out, they had to reopen her case. And so she had emailed us all and said, we should get together. And then unfortunately, she was the one that didn't turn up. Uh-huh. But a couple of the other girls weren't even considered victims. They were part of the tendency evidence, which was what his appeal was on. Because so there was 5 of us that went to court. There was 18 that the police knew of.
Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
And so everyone thinks it's me, and it's just me, but there's actually a whole group of us.
Well, brave old you.
Yeah. You're amazing.
Good on you.
To speak to these other women, because I'm sure for the longest time you thought it was just you.
Yeah, and I did know of other girls.
Okay.
Because I remember as a child on set when his daughter came and handed him a letter because she had to change high schools. Because he had molested two girls at the school. And they instead of doing anything, and they simply made her move.
Wow.
And so she went to a new school. And I remember that very vividly. And then we had rumours. And then after I left, of course, there was other people on the set that he molested. And then when I came forward, I didn't realise how many there were and how extensive it was into his, there's a lot of his relatives. And some of those showed up yesterday. And so he was very...
What about from the industry? Because it is so brave to stand up and to say, this has happened to me. Has there been blowback from the entertainment industry?
There really was at first. But I think if I'd lived in Australia, I would not have come forward, especially if I still wanted to be in the industry. Mm. But so when I came forward, it was like the year that Corey Haim died, and there had been a whole bunch of other kids who had experienced similar stuff, and it was just, there was the chatter. And I'm like, this is it. Nobody can do this anymore, and I'm not working, so it doesn't affect my career, so I will be the one to do it.
Do you think you lost work because of you
I have since, I've had my publicist has put me forward for stuff during the thing, and everyone's like, oh no, she's tainted. And not family viewing because people don't want to see her, because then we have to explain why she's here and it's not, it's not family conversation. And so there was a lot of, you are not really welcome unless we're doing an interview about that.
So amazing.
Why? Because you're too. You're a troublemaker, or they.
Because apparently.
I think it's just perception, isn't it?
Well, and there's still that stigma, which we need to get rid of, is when you are a victim of sexual assault, people look at you like it's your fault.
Yes.
Or you've got some kind of disease. Whereas if you were in a terrorist bombing, or you were robbed in a bank, or had a car accident, people are like, oh, you know, it happened to you, you were a victim, you know, let's move on. But for some reason, people look at, like, everyone was all on Robert's side, and I'm like, he's the one that was molesting kids, and I'm like, I was a child, and
you
all the others.
You were seven, weren't you, Sarah?
Yeah, and like I found out yesterday, one of the other girls was 3.
No way.
And then there was like all the way up to like 18, but and then he hit on anything basically in a skirt. But yeah, it was like so many, like just and but everyone looks at us, and I'm like, he's the bad guy, and no victim should have that shame. And as long as we have that shame, people won't come forward and speak.
One of the surprising things about the decision is it was so close. It was 3-4.
Yeah.
So 3 judges actually thought he should get a retrial. What was, before the decision came down, how scared were you that he was going to get off and this was all going to be for nothing?
I really tried not to focus on it, because the last time I let it eat at me and I got a little bit crazy, and my husband was like, just, you need to chill. Mm. And so this time I just, and everyone kept saying, it's not going to happen. Mm. But we had thought when he first went, because when he first appealed to the High Court, they had the decision right there to say, we're not even going to hear it. Mm. And everyone said, they're not even going to hear it, it's going to be fine. And I remember that day thinking, today's the day it's over. And it was the first time I'd let myself get optimistic. Mm. And I had this moment and I celebrated, and then they called and said, we're going.
Oh, no. But you celebrated though last night.
I did.
You? What did you do? What did you do?
So my really good friend J-Mo, he'd actually come to court with me and held my hand. And then so I went and visited another network. And then we all went out to dinner, and then J-Mo was at home, and my case affected him really badly. And so he called and he's like, come over and drink wine with me. And so we went over there and we were up to like 1 o'clock in the morning.
Good work. Oh, I endorse that.
I'm glad.
Yeah, good on you.
And you look very fresh for it too.
You have great makeup.
And we can't wait to see your clothing label too. Yes. So onwards and upwards.
Yes, they will definitely happen now. So.
Empowered. Seizing the power back for you.
It's
good
so
for you.
So true. And you've also got this wonderful book as well. It's called Allegedly, and it can be bought from Sarah's website, sarahmonahan.com. You are a fabulous woman, and we are so happy the Nightmare is here.
Yeah.